And then I moved because I was just kind of like, eh, you know what? Like, I'm over this. Like, and here's, like, just, like, a fun opportunity. So maybe I'll just, like, move to Montreal. And I was like, Montreal's a cool city. I can join a band from there.
Right.
Like, I had met the guys who were in some bands, but a lot of, like, French guys. I didn't really know the French-English kind of, like, split in Montreal as well. I could speak a bit of French, but... Anyways, I was like, I'm going to move to Montreal. And because I was young, I was just like, I'm out of here. See you, Troy.
Right.
So I moved to Montreal, and I was there for 4 years, just kind of, like, hanging out.
Okay.
Like, I worked a job. I was, like, going to lots of shows.
It's got a really good, interesting scene in Montreal.
Montreal had a sick scene, and it was, like, even though I wasn't playing at the time, like, it was great to be, like, seeing, especially, like, that was, like, when Arcade Fire, like, Wolf Parade... Like, the Unicorns, like, there was so much cool indie rock happening that was, like, super inspiring. I got to see tons of hip-hop. I got to see tons of, like, just, like, eclectic, like, tons of hardcore shows, too. Like, Sal X was going. So I just was more, like, just, like, taking in all of this music. I had a good job, so I was just, like, buying tons of music.
Oh, sweet.
Also, so just, like... Every CD I could ever get my hands on, I was just, like, consuming.
Well, and you had the job, too, so you had time to listen.
The job was, like, and it was cool, and Montreal is all about that. Like, it's not about, like, working hard and, like, doing... It's, like, go and chill. Yeah, get records. Go listen to them. Like, drink coffee and hang out. So that scene, I, like, kind of was like, oh, yeah, I get this.
Nice.
But then I was going back to Toronto, and I was, like, seeing all my friends that were, like, starting to do lots of cool stuff.
Okay.
So that was when, like, Alexis on Fire was, like, really starting to, like, pop.
Right.
And they were, like, coming through. They'd gotten signed to Distort. And I was, like, I had met those guys before when I was in another band. So I was just, like, oh, dudes, this is so sick.
Right.
But, like, Comeback Kid was also starting to, like, really, like, get some attention. And I was, like, oh, this is really cool.
So it became a thing that could happen for real.
Yeah, I was, like, seeing how much, like, my friends' bands. And I, like, wanted to be a part of that, but I didn't have anybody... who was doing that in Montreal.
Right.
So then Scott and I basically started Cancer Bats while I still lived in Montreal.
Okay.
So he worked for Via Rail. It was, like, really easy for him to come. So the first few jams were actually, like, in Montreal.
Mm-hmm.
And it was me playing drums and him playing guitar. And I was like, dude, let's do this. So we, like, wrote some riffs, and it was, like, sounding really cool. And then I convinced my friend Andrew, the guy from Ottawa, to play bass in it.
Mm-hmm.
And then we found a drummer. Because we were also just like, I live in Montreal, this isn't going to be like a serious band, but it'll be fun.
Right.
We can just do it. And Scott was in At the Mercy of Inspiration at the time. So that was like, oh, this band, they were like going to get signed. They were starting to tour in the States. They were starting to play all over the place. So we were like, oh,
so
sick.
We already had a taste. Yeah.
And he was like doing some cool stuff. So I was already like, I would come down in the summer, and when I was around, I would, like, go on tour with them. I would, like, sell merch for them.
Oh, okay.
Like, I was, like, really good friends with all those dudes. So I was like, oh, I'll just come and hustle your merch because, like, that's something I can do.
Mm-hmm.
So I would do that a lot. And then Cancer Bats was going at the same time. This was summer of 2004. And At the Mercy of Inspiration, short form At Moi is what we would call it. They were supposed to do a Western Canadian tour.
Okay.
So I got a month off of work, and I was like, I'm going to go on this tour for a month. It's going to be sick. I'm going to sell merch. We can kind of, like, hustle Cancer Bats as well. But it was still early days. Like, we had, like, a very rough cassette demo. Or maybe we even had, like, this CD demo at that point. But anyways, we were, like, very, like, early days. No, we hadn't even recorded our CD demo. So we had, like, cassette demos. And, so I was, like, gonna go on this tour, and then literally we played Sudbury, and the, like, guy who was setting up the tour was like, dudes, don't come on the tour. Like, all of the shows have fallen through. Like, obviously just, like, kind of, like, last minute being like, I blew it.
Ooh.
Like, this is super sketchy. Please don't, like, commit to doing this.
At least he was good enough to tell you before you hit the road.
Yeah.
That's better than a lot of promoters.
There was, like, a bunch of kind of, like, obviously stuff that, like... Like, the band was just like, what are we doing?
Yeah.
And all this stuff. And I was like, okay, well, I've already got the month off of work. So I went to Scott and I was like, why don't we just work on Cancer... Like, I'll stay in Toronto. I'll stay with Andrew. And we can just, like, work on Cancer Bats, like, every single day. And he was, like, sick. Because I think he kind of caught the vibe that, like, his band was sort of like on its way out.
Right.
Like that was like a last kind of like, yeah. So he was like super down. So I was like, okay, so we jammed like for a month, we just jammed every single day.
That's pretty fucking, and that's that was fundamental.
Like, kind of like seeing that opportunity and talking to the singer of Scott's band was just like, yeah, man, like go do it.
And that was
like the dude who I was like, I'm going to do this. And he was like, yeah, you should go for it. Cause I don't know what's happening with this band.
Nice.
So I was like, okay, cool.
That's really cool, man. That's really big of that dude.
Yeah. Oh, and it was sick. Cause he wanted to go to Japan. Like he was like, he had his mind on other things too. So I was like, okay, we're cool. And like the other guys, they don't care.
Right.
So I was like, okay. So then me, Scott and Andrew like started really hitting it. And that's when we recorded.
Dude, going every day for a month. That's like getting 3 years of fucking practices in.
Oh, yeah.
You know, well, if you're getting like, together once a fucking week, you know what I mean? Like, because that's your standard bands and shit, right?
But that was by the time, so I was 24.
Right.
So by, like, starting a band that's not doing anything, and for us...
There's no point.
Well, no, that was like, we either need to, like kind of hit it.
Yeah.
Like, and do this. And that was where I was, like, looking at, like, I was friends with the guys in Wolf Parade. Like, I was really close to Arcade Fire. Like, right. I saw, like... dudes going from like playing like a house show to like doing a full US tour and coming back and like being minted.
And you saw what it
was. And I was like, yeah. Oh, well, like obviously we're gonna do a hardcore band and that's way different. But like Alexis on Fire was like, dudes, like do this.
That's amazing.
Like come on tour with us.